Welcome to Seed to Life. In this episode today, we are going to see a special plant that is very ancient. Countries in Asia and Africa have been growing this plant for about 4,000 years. It was brought to the United States by plantation workers, and later it became very famous because of its high fat content. We are going to see sesame seeds plants today. Nutty and flavorful sesame seeds are used in various sweet and savory dishes in India. Not just in India, but in most Asian, African, and Middle Eastern countries, both sesame seeds and oil are an integral part of the local cuisine. It is a summertime crop, so after harvest, in fall, sesame seeds are used along with jaggery to make many sweet dishes. In olden days, when multivitamins were not available, sesame seeds, other dry fruits, jaggery, and ghee was used to make the foods that provided various multivitamins directly from the food. Fat content of the sesame seeds is about 44 to 60%. That is why it is used to make sesame oil. Sesame oil is a healthier replacement for the saturated oils in our diet, as well as it is used as skin and hair care product. Now let's see how to grow this special herb. I had both black sesame seeds and white sesame seeds in my kitchen, and I prefer using unpolished sesame seeds so they don't have the top coat removed. I used these unpolished sesame seeds and I planted both black and white ones. Most white sesame seeds sprouted, but the black ones they didn't make. After sprouting, the temperatures in my area started rising rapidly, and I lost most of these tiny delicate seedlings, except three. So even though sesame likes high temperatures, it is necessary to protect the new seedlings from extreme temperatures in the early period. Unfortunately, I don't have the pictures and videos of my seedlings, but I'm planning to plant black sesame seeds again. So maybe in my next video, I'll be able to share with you the seedlings videos. Once the seedlings mature, they start growing rapidly. In just few weeks, I moved them to a bigger pot. In a month or so, beautiful bell-shaped white flowers started appearing. You can see here two flowers on either side of the stalk and a tiny bud above them. I have planted my sesame plants along with eggplant. Pollination occurs mostly by beneficial insects, and small pods develop at the bottom of flowers. These pods soon become long, up to 1 to 1.5 inches in length. At first, they are green in color. Sesame plant leaves and pods are covered with hair-like structures that gives the plant very shiny and velvety appearance. You can see here maturing green pods. Now they are growing in length and they are about 1 to 1.5 inches in length. Soon these pods will turn yellow. It takes about 3 to 4 weeks to turn them yellow or mature completely. And you can see here the leaves, they are getting narrower and smaller as compared to the leaves when the plant was younger. This happens with most plants. This way, plants can put more energy to developing fruits and reduce the energy supply to other parts such as leaves. Here the pods have started turning yellow. The maturation starts from the bottom of the stem and progresses upwards. At this time, you can harvest the pods and let them dry. Now what will happen if you wait too long? In that case, pods open up and the seeds spill in the soil, and then sesame plants will grow like weeds. So if you don't want them to grow everywhere, it is better to harvest them before pods open. Here you can see one of the pods is already open and the seeds are going to fall off anytime. Let's harvest these pods before it is too late. I'm taking out the... Did you see what happened? This is what I was talking about. Here are some of the pods that I have harvested from my plants earlier. And they are still closed and some of them are partly green, and let's see how to take the seeds out now. You can see that these pods, they have four compartments, and when I'm pinching this seed pod, the seeds are not coming out. Maybe the pod is not completely ready. I waited for a few more days, and when the pods were finally ready, you can see here they were completely dry and it was very easy to take the seeds out. I just had to pinch the pods and the seeds were coming out. Here, let's see one more time. And I'm done with harvesting my seeds. And these seeds are from 10 to 12 pods that I collected that day. Now you must be wondering why some of the seeds that we buy from the grocery store are white in color and very shiny, and these seeds look brown. So because these seeds, they are not hulled. Hulling means removing husks or the outer coats of the grains by milling and polishing. I prefer the unpolished sesame seeds because they are more flavorful and less processed. I believe they are healthier, but there are some differences in the amount of nutrients that you can get from hulled and unhulled sesame seeds. Not going in detail now, but you can refer to the links in the description section if you are interested. Some recipes like tahini, where you need very smooth texture, might require hulled seeds. But it is up to you what you like, and you can pick the ones that you want. Here is a quick recipe of garlic sesame chutney. To some oil, just add 2 cloves of garlic and roast them properly. Then you add the sesame seeds, and on a low flame you have to roast the seeds until you get the nutty aroma of the sesame seeds. Then add some salt and paprika or red chili powder, and then grind this into a fine powder just for a few seconds to get this nice and flavorful chutney. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to my channel Seed to Life for more videos and updates. Click on the bell icon to get notified about the new videos. Thank you again. See you soon.